What's up everyone, and welcome to the third video of the Exploratory Data Analysis Hack series. If you haven't checked out the first two videos, I'll just put the link of the playlist in the description. You can just go ahead and check it out. I'm sure it'll be worth your time. So in this video, we'll be plotting a simple decision tree within a matter of minutes. By simple, I mean, you know, the decision tree has, the data set has a very few number of variables involved. Let me just show you the data set which I'll be running. I'll be running the iris data set, and this is how it looks. So as you can see, it has a sepal length, weight, petal length, petal width, and the species. So this will be our target variable because it's categorical. And I've loaded this data sets using sklearn.datasets package. I've done that because it's an inbuilt package. I've probably manipulated this data set a lot, so I didn't want to use it. Or I didn't want to write 2-3 extra lines of code just to, you know, import the CSV file. So let me just quickly run this. I've already run it, but I'm just gonna go ahead and run it anyway. Alright, okay. So I've just imported the general libraries which we'll be using for this hack, and as I said, I've used the sklearn.datasets. I've used sklearn package and use the datasets module there to load our iris dataset, and I'll be using the same package to load a module called tree, which will help us fit our decision tree classifier. I've objectified that to CLF with a seed value, and I've objectified the dataset to iris, to the name iris. So I fit this to an object. Again, I've overwritten on it on CLF. This is iris.data, which is our independent variable, and iris.target, which is our categorical dependent variable, basically our Y. Let me just quickly show you this. I think it's better to show how this looks. So yeah, so this is the reason why I decided to load it from the sklearn.datasets. If I had to load this, I would have probably had to sort of encode it, and you know, to setosa to zero, like, or versicolor to one, and virginica to two. So I didn't want to do that extra step. So, you know, it's time saved, and you know, this is a hack. So I want you guys to save your time. So yeah, that's the target variable. And I'll be fitting the tree using this function called tree.plot_tree. Now, before, we had something called as GraphViz, and that is also pretty cool. It looks better in my opinion. Let me just increase the figure size. Alright, okay, I think this is good. Alright, so I filled it, as you can see here, with colors to distinguish between the different nodes, and based on the Gini value, it's going to split. Like, if the Gini is 0, it's going to stop splitting. I'm sure you know about Gini if you have studied about decision trees. And so again, this is a very cool way to look at your your decision tree. And why is this an EDA step? So this can be considered an EDA step because here we're actually trying to determine, we're trying to develop a framework where we can understand what our decision variables are and how is the likelihood or the outcome. Likelihood is not the right word. I'll say probability of the outcome of our desired variables. All right. So it's going to split until the maximum depth, that is here, and wherever Gini is 0 is going to stop splitting. Like, as you can see, Gini is 0 here, it's going to stop splitting there. And if you want to understand how the splitting occurred, you can use this tree.exportText function, which is also pretty cool because, you know, it helps you understand. So this is good if you have a lot of variables, because this will keep on going like till here. Like, it's going to go until from here till here, you know, somewhere here, if you have a lot of variables. But I have only four, as I showed you, I have only like five variables here, so it has split according to that. And as you can see, the same way, like here, when the third variable was less than 0.8, it has split that. The third independent variable, which was less than 4.8, has split that. If it was less than 0.8, the class would have been 0. If it was greater than 0.8, it's splits further. All right, so accordingly you can understand. So This was another cool way. Many people do not know how to do this, surprisingly. So I thought it's worth sharing. And if you have any further queries on this, or if you would like to correct me if I've done something wrong, please do let me know in the comments below. As I said, I'm again a student. I may be not 100% correct on this, but I did my research, and you know, I have done this correctly. I can guarantee you that. So again, thank you so much for watching this video. Do subscribe to my channel, and until next time, see you guys later.